Yes, guys. So let us consider how many students are joining in a college in a particular branch. How many people are entering into the second year? How many are third year? Then final year? Then coming away from the third.
Hello.
Every year.
Lateral.
Passing semester exams, going to the next year. Likewise, in the next year again, two semesters, clearing those semester exams, going to the next year. Let us consider in one company, assume civil engineering. 60 people joined in the civil engineering branch. Out of 60 people, assume 55 people entered into the second year by successfully clearing first two semesters. Out of these 55 people entered into third year, while entering into third year, 65 people because of their clerks or because of health issues, because of some personal issues, are able to enter into third year. So maybe 50 people entered into third year. 50 people entered into third year. So from third year, only 45 people entered into final year because of some or other. Out of 45, only 40 people cleared from the final year. Civil engineering branch, while joining 60 people were there. Once graduation completely got over, 40 people came out from the college with a graduation degree. Out of this 40 people, assume only 10 people scored more than 70%, then 20 people scored 50 to 60, then 10 people scored less than 50%. 40 people came out from the college. Out of 40, 10 people scored more than 60, 20 people scored between 50 to 60, 10 people scored less than 50, but all are clear. So here, so whoever scored more than 60%, definitely they will be having a lot of confidence. They will be keep searching jobs here and there. So definitely those people we can consider like a vital people. They can able to search here and there, they will be getting some or other jobs. The people between 50 to 60, they will be having a less confidence. Those people will be keep on thinking like maybe unable to get into the any industry, my score is not very proper. The people who scored less than 50 but still they have cleared the certificate, they will be thinking like, I may not be able to get any kind of job in any field. So let me stay back in the house doing something whichever family is doing. So diversive type of people are they. I considered only civil engineering. I considered 60 people, 40 cleared the graduation. Even though they have cleared the graduation, three different types of people we have seen. The people who scored more than 60%, the people who are between 50 to 60, the people less than 50. What about the people who were not able to clear, like 20 people? Definitely they might be clearing their graduation in a maximum a year or two. After 1 year or after 2 years, definitely they will be clearing. So even though they have cleared, they also will be in these three scenarios: greater than 60%, between 50 and 60, between less than. So now we can consider four kinds of people. So whoever with backlogs finishing, whoever first attempt more than 60%, whoever first attempt between 50 to 60, whoever first attempt less than 50%. All these people, I considered civil engineering, all are trying to get some job because of after graduation, definitely they should earn something to the family. They had to do something. Whoever having a more confidence, those people trying to search in diverse areas like government jobs, civil engineering jobs, and some kind of people going to the IT field, some people looking for some kind of business, reception, government jobs, some kind of business, some people entering into IT, some people working with the family related businesses, some people continuing as a lecturers in the same college or in other colleges, diverse. For all these fields, more than 60% of people only very aggressively going, let me do civil engineering jobs, or let me write some competitive exams, or let me think about some software jobs, or let me think about some kind of business. The people who are less than 60%, they're not very aggressive in the beginning. They keep observing other friends or other seniors or relatives, what they are doing. Let me find one suitable. And the people who are less than 50, they're almost like a very, something like a discouraged. They're not taking decisions immediately. And the people who are passed out after backlogs, those people are much more discouraged. They are almost like a very under very depression, unable to choose a field. For all these type of people, first year difficulty, second year maybe little easy, third year maybe little. After considering 5 years, after 5 years, I can say 90% of people working in the software in any of the areas. I taken one example. With the example only, I am coming across. All these four types of people, if we consider after 5 years, 90% of people, out of 60 intake into the civil engineering, I can see minimum 50 people in down the line after 5 years, they're in the software, either in the testing field or in the Java field or in the SAP field, or at least like a some kind of maintenance, or at least some kind of recruitment jobs. Indirectly, software is involving. Minimum 50% of people are in the software after 5 years of school. I'm just talking about civil engineering, which is like a almost not at all related to IT any at any cost. Even though they know basics of C or C++ in the graduation, their thinking will be moving to the civil engineering side. Most of the people not at all thinking about IT. But after 5 years, 90% of people entering into the IT only. So maybe in the first year, few people, in the second year, few people, third year, then finally, fourth year, fifth year, after finishing the graduation, I'm talking. So civil engineering, 90% of people entering into the software after 5 years. The reasons are lot more. Why civil engineering people finally surviving in the software itself? Not immediately, I am saying, after 5 years we can see. Why? There are two reasons. More jobs are made not there in the civil engineering compared to computer science. The main, a very important one, more jobs are not there in the civil engineering. I can say like a, only 5% of civil engineering graduates getting a job in their core field. 95% of people somehow entering into the subject. Not only civil engineering people, even other branches also same. 5% of people only able to survive in their core field, remaining people finally entering into software. Through my experience, I'm telling you, I've seen some thousands together students, thousands together colleges passing out people. Based on all that, I'm telling, in the core field, just maximum 5% of people surviving, continuing, remaining 95% of people entering back into the software. So because of more jobs, this is one reason. The second reason, while considering growth, in the civil engineering, definitely growth is there. I cannot say like a growth is not there. Definitely growth is there. But while comparing with the software, growth is little less. Assume, today civil engineering getting a job with a salary of 20,000. Software engineer getting a job with a salary of 10,000. After 5 years, civil engineer maximum his salary may be 40,000. Software engineer, definitely his salary will be minimum to minimum 1 lakh. There are people who are getting 1.5 lakhs also within 5 years span, even though their starting salary, it was only 10,000. So because of exponential growth, everybody trying to enter into software field. Less jobs in the core field and less like a progress. In the software, more jobs are there. And also, more growth. Year to year, salary is almost like a 30%, 40% is increasing. It's purely based on how you are performing. So because of all these things, let everybody start thinking about software while they are in the graduation. While in the final year of graduation, if they keep thinking about the software, definitely they can minimize their 5 years span after graduation to 1 year or maybe 2 years. Within 1 year, they can able to enter into the software, or at least within 2 years, they can able to enter into the software. Please try to remember, final ultimate goal to all average students, it's a software. So forget about the toppers, no matter whether they're surviving in the software or in the core field or doing some constructions or doing some business or doing with the family. We don't require to bother about the toppers. They can place any way. Consider average students. Average students' ultimate goal is a software only. Maybe statistically, you can just take one paper, one pen, and write down all your friends, seniors, relatives, whoever graduated in the technical, BE, BTech. You can just note their names. Finally, you can check it out where they are working. Find out their branches. Based on the branches, based on their finally working. 95% of people you can find like a software only, not the core field. So that is why my sincere advice, try to improve your software skills in the graduation itself. But at the same time, don't neglect your graduation. Always advisable to get more percentages. That percentages will be giving effect to your throughout your life. In the final year, if you are thinking like let me get more percentages. Then focus on your core field, get more percentages. So, without neglecting your graduation, advisable to travel in the software also. In the software, we need to identify which kind of skills is suitable for all average students. So, how to learn? How long it will be taking? How much time is required? So, all those things I will be discussing with you. So, as of now, we have seen different types of graduates, like with respect to their percentages and all. Any percentage person can able to enter into the software, no matter whether they score less than 50% or greater than 60%. Any percentage of people can able to enter into the software field. Then, the second point, to enter into the software, aptitude, reasoning and GD. Aptitude, reasoning and group discussion. Most of the people thinking like these three are mandatory to enter into software field. Aptitude, reasoning and GD. Yes, it is mandatory only for 5% of companies. Please observe. Aptitude, reasoning, group discussion, very mandatory just for 5% of companies in the industry. Most of the studying people, they keep on going through R.S. Agarwal or some other aptitude and reasoning, even though they are unable to finish off most of the concepts, even though they are getting some kind of bore or something. I can say just 5% of companies required very much aptitude, reasoning and group discussion. 95% of companies not at all bothering about aptitude, reasoning and group discussion. Everybody having a minimum knowledge in the mathematics, we didn't bypass our high school study. We studied mathematics till to high school. Most of the 95% of people continued mathematics even in the plus 2, and at least like 40 to 50% of people continued mathematics in the graduation. Whatever aptitude reasoning we are talking, that is high school mathematics, everybody having aptitude and reasoning. If you have a more patience and if you are having a more interest on practicing, go through aptitude and reasoning. There is no wrong on practicing aptitude and reasoning. But don't think like that is only software life. Think like only 5% of companies required this aptitude and reasoning. Even communication. Most of the people studying high school in the mother tongue, like in Hindi medium or in Telugu medium or Kannada medium. Then they are entering English medium in the plus 2. Some people even plus 2 also in their own regional languages. Then entering into the English in the BE or BTech. So some people may not be having a good communication. One point you have to observe here. Communication very much required in case of private organizations. Communication very much required in case of private organizations. Especially in the software, communication is very much required. Very, very much required. Always try to improve. Always try to improve. But don't consider with communication only we can able to enter into the industry. Most of the people attending soft skills classes, some training related classes, something like a spoken English and all. Those and all not required. We are not going to explain Bahubali movie to the interviewers. We are going to explain our technical things. While explaining technical things, you don't require ins and outs of grammatical things. You don't require complete grammar related tenses and all. you require how to compose a simple sentence to explain a subject. 4 years in the BTech, you are studying different subjects in English. You keep listening to your lecturers on English itself, each and every sentence. You are preparing for the exams, you are representing in the semester exams, mid exams and all. That itself a communication for the technical person. We are not the HR people, we are not the recruiters, we are not salesperson, we are not the marketing person. We don't require to explain any history in English, any movie in English, only technical things. So, whatever communication you have, that is highly sufficient. Only the thing is, you should have some kind of drilling, composing technical sentences. While going through any lecturer session, please observe how your lecturers composing the sentences. How they are like a framing multiple words as a sentence to explain any kind of definition, any kind of difference, any kind of advantage, any kind of limitation, any kind of process, procedure, same try to represent. So, according to me, aptitude not a mandatory, reasoning not a mandatory, communication also not a mandatory, but all these three keep improving if possibility is there. If there is no possibility, don't keep thinking about negative. So don't be bothering about that. Don't depress it. So keep improving and at the same time give a more difference to technical. So forget about your percentages. Forget about your branches. Forget about your communication. Forget about your aptitude content, reasoning content, but always try to improve if possibility is there. If there is no possibility, don't worry about those things. Then there are some people who are worrying about programming skills. Even some CSE student itself thinking, my programming capabilities are very less. I may not be suitable for the programming. Let me entering into the testing field. Let me entering into the network field. Let me enter into the administration. That is not correct. Programming, it is not a difficult. Please observe. Programming is not a difficult. In the mathematics, in whichever way you are adding two numbers, in whichever way you are finding out square root of two numbers. In the mathematics, in whichever way you are finding out interest rates. Seeing how to represent in the programming languages. What is the variable required? What is the block, like a conditions related or iterations related? What kind of blocks or what kind of iterations? What kind of methods required? It is just a matter of 10 days study. Even 10th class student can able to compose programs for adding two numbers, for finding out prime number, Fibonacci series, even calculating interest rates, how we can take the input from the customer, processing. For the processing purpose, which formula we have to use? To develop that formula, what are the variables required? Finally, getting a result of that formula, showing that formula result to the customer. It's not at all difficult. Definitely in the initial 10-15 days only, you might be getting little confusion, little difficult, but it's not difficult. I can say programming is almost like a human language. Please observe. In the human language, whatever names are there, whatever pronounce, whatever nouns, all we will be seeing in the programming languages also. So it's not at all difficult if you know very basics of any mathematics or any kind of a process. Even BA people also able to understand programming. Don't think like programming is a difficult. Only the thing is sincerity, seriousness. If you are a very sincere person, 200%, 200% you can able to understand. Initially, just a matter of 10-15 days, you might be finding a difficulty. Without a difficulty, there's no life. But the difficulty is not continuing throughout the life. Just initial. In any field, initial 10 days, there will be a difficulty. First 10 days, afterwards, you can learn anything. You can learn anything. Please observe. Placing topper in the Google, placing topper in the Facebook is not a difficult task. Please observe. Placing graduate with a just 2 lakhs package, that's a great achievement. Very great achievement. My focus will be graduate. So my focus will be average student placing in the development side with a minimum package of 2 to 2.5 lakhs. So instead of wasting your time 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years after finishing your graduation, as soon as graduation is getting over, in spite of your percentages, your earlier backlogs, not I'm telling current backlogs, earlier backlogs, and you have cleared, no matter of your current total final percentage, 10th class percentage or plus 2 percentage or any kind of limitations, but you have a graduation cutoff, you have a graduation certificate, that is sufficient for us to place you in the industry. Lakhs together companies don't think about your programming level, whether you are an average student or above average student or below average student, whatever it may be, whether you have a good aptitude, good reasoning or not, communication or not. I required from your side very seriousness. Lot of seriousness is very much required. If that is the case, within 3 to 4 months span, I can place you in the industry with a minimum to minimum. 2 lakhs. The average salary, I can promise you, like 3.5 lakhs. Lot of companies, lakhs together companies require a sincere students who are having programming capabilities. No matter of their previous negatives like percentages, year of pass outs, even communication. So no need of bothering about that. Only programming capabilities. I can say 95% of companies not at all conducting aptitude reasoning exams. Most of the studying students, college students, they keep bothering about aptitude reasoning. You can talk to your seniors, your well-wishers, how many number of colleges keeping aptitude and reasoning? Only 5% of companies. How many companies are there in Bangalore? Lakhs together companies. You know maximum 1,000 companies in Bangalore. Please observe. Minimum 3 lakhs companies are there in Bangalore. If anybody writing all the known names of the colleges, he cannot write more than 1,000. He knows only 1,000 companies. But in Bangalore, 3 lakhs companies are there. Assume in the known companies, in all the companies, aptitude is there. So 2 lakhs, 99 companies, not at all considering aptitude, reasoning and your communication level. So they are focusing on your programming capabilities, programming understanding, whether you can able to implement customer logic, customer task instantly or not. That is very much required. please observe this point. Most of the companies, they wanted you to apply a customer logic, a customer requirement instantly, immediately. You should get the way of implementing a logic. If you have a very strong in the programming, that is sufficient. To become a strong in the programming for a graduate, it won't take more than 2 months. But sincerity is required. Graduate means just an average student. I'm not talking about a topper or extraordinary. I'm talking about the average graduate doesn't require more than 2 months to become an expert in the programming. But every day, he has to show a lot of interest. With more interest, every day, keep going through covering portion, covered portion, very constantly. It won't take more than 2 months at all. Within 2 months, you'll become an expert, which is required for 95% of companies. So please try to focus on programming rather than bothering about whatever negatives you have. Let me check. 1 second. Okay, some messages are typed in the chat window. I'll cover all those messages while ending. So while ending the discussion, so please observe. Subject, if you have a subject, more companies will run behind you. Most of the mid-range companies and even startup companies, they will be looking for the people who can implement their customer logic, customer requirements instantly, immediately, rather than taking the time. So you can see Amazon or even Google or even Facebook. Everywhere logics are required. Please observe. Anybody can learn the concepts while coming to apply. There you required a lot of logical power. What are the different ways available to find out a square root? What are the different ways available to find out the square of two numbers? What are the different ways available? Please observe. To interact with the database, to interact with the web service, to interact with the file system. So lot more among all, which is the best one, shortest one, and smart one. Whoever knowing that one, those people can implement with a quality way of the solution. Always customers looking for a quality way, for the quality, definitely you require more practice in the programming. My sincere advice to all the graduates, please observe. There is no average, below average, extraordinary and toppers in this software. Below average student also drawing more salary compared to topper of a college. Let us consider from one college, one person is a topper, one person is a below average. After 5 years, if you are comparing, in some scenarios, below average student drawing more salary than topper. So, I came to in front of you to explain the importance of the subject. Don't worry about your branches. It can be a civil, it can be a mechanical, it can be triple E, ECE, it can be even IT with below average, it can be CSE with below average, even MCA with below average, even BSc. But it's better to have a mathematics stream rather than any pure science stream. BSc any mathematics or MSc with a at least like a 1 or 2 years mathematics study. For all those people, it's very easy to enter into the software. Only the thing is, you should have a seriousness. You can just think it out. How many days sincerely you practiced in a span of 6 months? No one taken a seriousness in a span of 6 months to practice very well. Now, almost you reach to the final year. This is the time to spend max to max 3 to 4 months. Whatever content I'll be covering, for that content, daily just to 3 hours additionally. Likewise, go for 3 months, maximum 3 months, minimum 2 months. 200% I can place you. It is not a difficult. Before finishing your graduation, placing in a company. As soon as graduation is getting over, joining in the same company. Definitely, I can make it true. For some people, it may be a dream, but it is not a dream. It will become a actual. If you just follow me, in addition to my class, if you are just practicing maximum 2 to 3 hours, that will be sufficient. No matter whether you still have a backlog or not. No matter whether your percentage is 50 or 60. If you have a backlog, so definitely you have to clear that one after clearing OBE. So do parallelly effort for clearing the backlogs and even practicing my content. That is sufficient. So software industry, it is not for one type of people. Most of the people thinking like it. It's a programming, it's very difficult, only toppers or only extraordinary candidates. No. Any person, any graduate, they should not have a backlog. So just to graduate, any branch, it can be BE any branch, it can be mathematics, BSc, that is sufficient to enter into the got it. Then, so while entering into the software field, lot of streams are there. Which stream is more suitable? Most of the people keep hearing about Java, C, C++, testing, networking, database, SAP, some big data. Recently, you might be keep hearing about data science. Lot more are there. Which one is suitable? For any type of person, which one is suitable? Please observe, among all these things, fresher. Fresher has to work in the programming for at least 3 to 5 years. Please focus on this point. Fresher, no matter of any branch, no matter of any branch, fresher should work minimum 3 to 5 years in the programming. It can be a C, it can be C++, it can be Java, it can be a .NET, or it can be any object-oriented programming language, whichever it may be in the programming. Don't go for administration side, like a database administration. Don't go for networking side. Don't go for big data Hadoop. Most of the people spoiling their career choosing big data Hadoop. That is not for the freshers. At least you should have a 3 to 5 years of programming knowledge to understand each and every system from the ecosystem of Hadoop and Big Data. Most of the people thinking like a lot of salary, more salary in the Big Data and Hadoop, let me enter. You cannot become an expert in all the areas of ecosystem of Big Data And some of the people, they are thinking like, let me enter into the data science. Even that also required minimum 3 to 5 years of experience. So don't worry about which skills are having a more salary, which skills having a more salary. If you keep thinking about salary wise, definitely there are some technologies which fresher cannot understand, cannot enter into, cannot like become an expert. So mainly big data, Hadoop, data science, in the same way SAP. Most of the people right from the, not only now, even 10 years back also, all elders guiding, these skills are having a more salary, please try to learn that skills. That is not absolutely correct. Please consider programming for initial 3 years. Hardcore programming. It can be even RAS C++ or object oriented Java or any .NET or any other object oriented programming languages. This is the first and foremost you have to observe. Then, among this programming, which one is advisable? Which one is not advisable? So here, two things are there. Based on these two things, you can consider which one is advisable, which one is not advisable. First one, number of concepts in the programming language. In the programming language, how many concepts, how much vast is developed? How much vast is developed? How many number of concepts are there? That is first one. Then the second one, how much demand is there in the industry while considering in the current industry, how much demand is there? Definitely, you have to focus both. First one, how many days required to become an expert? That is based on number of concepts. Second one, how many days will take to enter into the companies? That is purely based on how much demand. So you need to consider how many number of skills are there in a particular programming language, like a concepts, or maybe like a how many number of days required to learn to become an expert. Second one, how many number of companies are looking? Companies are looking like a demand in the industry. So how many days it will take to enter into the company? Based on these two things, better to choose one programming language. If you consider C, it's not a very difficult because of it's completely a raw. No API development. There are few something like a predefined built-in functionalities are there. Very less API. It won't take more days to learn. You can become an expert very soon. But internally, more memory management is there. It looks like a little difficulty, but not more concepts. You can become very comfortable very soon. But in the industry, I can say like a very few companies only using. Very, very few companies only using. So because of the less demand, C may not be advisable. Then come to the C++. Compared to C++, learning is more, like a more API, more predefined, built-in concepts are there. Definitely, it will take more time compared to C. A little more time, and compared to C, requirements also little more, but not like a within 1 month we can able to place, or within 6 months we can able to place. It may take even 1 year also. Less number of requirements only. But compared to C, it's like a little more requirement. But not like a very frequently companies are calling with C++. This also not very advisable. Then, other Java and .NET. Let us discuss both parallel. Java and .NET. So, Java, little difficulty, more concepts. Java, little difficult, more concepts. .NET, whatever Java is having concepts, all are available in the .NET, but complexity is less. Less complexity, but all features of Java available in the .NET. You don't require to learn all the features whatever you are learning in Java. Please observe, in Java, whatever concepts are there, all those concepts you don't require to learn in the .NET, just because of in the .NET lot of predefined built-in concepts are there. So compared to Java, .NET learning is simple. Within 2-3 months you can become an expert. Java complexity is the more number of concepts. In .NET complexity is less. Concepts are very easy. Most of the concepts already predefined, drag and drop. So because of that, learning will be less. Less time will be taken to learn to become an expert compared to Java. Java will take more time. And moreover, it's a little difficult. Then, compared to job requirements, whatever project we are developing, that project, if you are choosing Java, same can be developed in .NET also. Java, same project can be developed in the .NET, but in India, 90% of projects are developing in the Java only. 90% of projects developing in the Java itself. .NET requirements are less, even though every Java project we can able to develop in the .NET. In India, 90% of projects choosing Java technologies to develop. Reason is, Java is a free software to use. Till now, Java is absolutely free to use. You don't require to buy any licenses. Based on Java, lot of other technologies are also built. .NET is not a free. On top of .NET, more technologies are not built. All the technologies are maintained by Microsoft itself, but every technology is a paid one. Customers are not able to buy the softwares from the Microsoft. So that is why, while comparing Java and .NET, you can say like both are having equal features. Java, because of less number of built-in features, it's a little difficult. .NET, because of more built-in features, it's little easy. So very quickly we can become an expert. But compared to requirements, Java having more requirements in India compared to .NET. Lot of reasons are there. Right? Among all the reasons, one reason which you can able to understand immediately, that is, Java is a free software. .NET is not a free. Likewise, lot of differences are there. Because of all these differences, in India, Java is widely used. So better to go for Java compared to .NET. Got it? Because of more requirements, even though it's like a more. But to become an expert in Java, definitely 6 months also may not be sufficient. There are people who are taking 8 months, 10 months, to become an expert in Java, just in core Java itself. On top of core Java, a lot of advanced things are developed in the industry. So there is a concept called JDBC, servlets, JSP, Spring, Hibernate, Struts, and also web services. Lot more things. On Java only, even Hadoop also developed. On Java only, even Selenium is developed. On Java only, even Android is developed. I can say like a Java J2E ecosystem is a vast, almost like a 20-25 technologies are there. To become an expert in all the technologies, definitely one life may not be sufficient. So, my sincere advice, not to choose Java in the beginning. Not to choose Java. Instead of Java, better to go for .NET. But .NET very less number of requirements, that is also not advisable to choose. Rolled out of C, C++, Java, .NET. These are only for the graduation semester exams purpose, not for the average student entering into the industry within a span of 2 months. Please observe, average student to enter into the industry in a span of 2-3 months of preparation, all these technologies not at all advisable. I'm not telling blindly, I'm telling based on my experience. I have a total 20 years of experience in the industry. So I have seen like a C, C++, Java, .NET, all these ecosystem of J2E, all those things. Because of all the things, what my sincere advice to all the average graduates, not C, not C++, Java, .NET, or even like any other technologies which you'll be hearing. Now, consider a technology wave, less number of concepts, easy to understand, and more demand. Please observe. Less number of concepts, easy to understand, and also more demand, easy to understand, very less number of concepts. So let us consider Java. With only Java, nobody will give a job. On top of Java, lot of J2E ecosystem you have to learn. So for that, it will be taking months together. So Java is not ruled out. Java is not at all advisable. So likewise, don't choose any programming language where lot of other dependencies required to develop a project. If you want to consider for Java project development, then interviewers are asking all the technologies which are required to develop a Java project. We cannot develop a project by using just core Java. Lot of advanced concepts very much required. Interviewer is expecting all those technologies from your side. It may take lot of time to learn. So beginner, fresher, as soon as graduation is getting over, let him to enter into the dynamic industry within a 2 months or 3 months span of the time, rather than wasting 1 year or 2 years. Keep learning is advisable. 1 year you are learning, 2 years you are learning, you are not wasting your time, you are keep learning. But compared to learning, if you are implementing in the companies, that will be giving lot of knowledge to your brain. So that is why, instead of spending years together only for learning, try to enter into the industry as soon as possible by choosing highly demanded and easily learning programming language. Enter into the companies, start implementing, and then start learning parallelly. Learning and implementing very parallelly. That will be giving more effect to your career. Your brain will become more sharp rather than only learning. Keep learning and implementing. That is why as soon as possible, it's better to enter into any kind of company with any technology, but development technology, not the testing, not the networking, not the administration, any kind of programming, whatever it may be. It can be any kind of programming. It should be in the development. Don't waste your years together for only learning purpose. As soon as your graduation is getting over, no matter of how much salary, no matter of what kind of programming language you are going to use, start implementing customer requirements. Lot more things you will be learning. For that, we need to identify a technology which is very easy and also highly demanded in the industry. So for the past 4-5 years statistics, I clearly observed. After observing all, I identified what are the technologies required to the fresher to enter into the industry. Like a fresher should act as a ready-made resource to the companies. With these skills, companies will take and immediately giving an opportunity. So those technologies, according to my previous understanding, is there are two technologies. One is Salesforce. Second one is UI development with Angular. One is a Salesforce. Second one is UI developer with Angular. Salesforce, it's very easy to understand. Non-computer science background also can able to understand very easily. There is no like a very complicated concepts. And even understanding very easily, we can able to understand very easily. Salesforce is using one of the object-oriented programming language, that is Apex. It's very simple compared to Java. I can say like a very similar to the Java, but compared to Java concepts, maximum 10% only in the Apex. The people, whoever knowing Java, for those people Apex is nothing, very simple. But to know Apex, you don't require a Java. Straight away, you can learn Apex. Max to max, within 1 month, you can become an expert in the Apex. Not more APIs, more concepts. Anybody can able to understand. And even in the Salesforce, lot of almost like a drag and drop functionalities are there. We can able to utilize built-in features which are already provided. So lot of custom something like a configuration available, we can able to use. Any kind of project we can able to develop. So nowadays, industry completely customer relation management. Any business required customers. Any business has to maintain customers very properly, getting new customers, retaining existing customers. Getting new customers, retaining existing customers is the biggest challenge. Almost for the past 20 years, customer relationship management. Salesforce is a customer relationship management tool or maybe a software. So customer relation management, CRM tool. So earlier, SAP was a CRM tool, but there, hardcore programming was not there, only configuration was there, and also very expensive for mid-range customers. Salesforce, it's very easy for mid-range customers. It's not a free compared to cost of the SAP. Salesforce is very negligible cost, and learning also very simple, and pure development is involved here. Not more built-in development like a SAP. Here also built-in is there. Here also built-in is there. But definitely we require to develop a lot of things. Developer can enjoy while implementing their own logic for customer requirements. So Salesforce, it won't take more than 2 months to become an expert. Within 2 months, you can become an expert. Nowadays, I can see like a 40% of companies in Bangalore using Salesforce. 40% of companies using Salesforce. 40% of companies having a requirement. Every company having a requirement in the Salesforce. So that is why it is always advisable to learn and entering into the Salesforce. In addition to this, I am covering even UI related Angular. So in case of any browser based technologies, even Salesforce we are using for browser based, even Salesforce internally using, and even we are also using some kind of UI technologies. Under UI technologies, so mainly HTML, HTML5, CSS, JavaScript and Angular. I will not be covering HTML, HTML5 and CSS. It's very easy. anybody can able to understand, 10th class student also can understand. Don't worry about non-computer science students. Everybody can able to understand HTML, HTML5 and CSS. I will be covering JavaScript and Angular ins and outs. It's very easy to understand. JavaScript, it's a simple programming language. It's not a 100% object oriented. It is using some kind of object oriented, but not fully. While moving to Angular, there is a TypeScript. It is a object oriented programming language. If you know Apex, or if you know Java, or if you know C++, you can easily understand a TypeScript. Even without knowing any other programming languages also, you can understand a TypeScript. One very important point, most of the people thinking like, first we have to learn C, then we have to learn C++, then only Java is possible, then only Apex is possible, then only TypeScript is possible. That is totally wrong, totally wrong. Please remember this point. Don't waste your time even a single day to learn C. Don't waste even a single day to learn C++. Straight away start Java, straight away start Apex, straight away start TypeScript. Please observe, it's not at all required C or C++ to learn any programming language. Now, every programming language is a full-fledged, concrete programming language. Every language surviving on its own, every programming language having all these features. If you know C, maybe initial 10% of study will become a simple. If you know C++, initial 10% of study will become a simple. That's all. So no need of knowing C before learning Java. No need of knowing C or C++ before learning Apex, before learning TypeScript. In our course content, we will be going through two object-oriented programming concepts, programming languages. One is Apex, second one is TypeScript. Through Apex, we will be developing one simple prototype project by using Salesforce. Even in the Angular also, I will be showing one simple crude activity, create, read, update, delete in case of Angular by making use of JSON server. Real time, you'll come to know exactly where we are using Angular, where we are using internally HTTP connections, all those things you'll come to know later. So here, Salesforce, 40% of companies are using Angular. I can say like more than 50% of companies are using. So altogether, in any company, either Salesforce or Angular requirement will be. You will become an expert in two diverse streams. One stream is a Salesforce, other stream is a Angular. In these two streams, maybe 20% is a interception concepts, common. 20 to 30% of concepts are common. You will be eligible for entering into Salesforce concepts and also Angular concepts. In addition to these two, very important point for the freshers. Everybody, to enter a fresher into the industry. In order to enter a fresher into the industry, what kind of mandatory information from the fresher? What kind of mandatory skills a fresher should require? Please observe everybody. In order to enter a fresher into the industry, he should require a very strong logical thinking. In our course content, I will be going through several logical coding programming. Logical, I can say like hundreds together in different topics. Lot of concepts are there. All those concepts you will be understanding, you will be developing. Without logical thinking, no company considering you as a software engineer. There are some people who entered into the industry without logical coding somehow, after 5-6 years, they are realizing, my base is not very proper. I need to understand very basic things very properly, then only I can move forward. Most of the people, after 10 years also, they are coming to the institutes and joining to understand how logics can be developed for a particular customer requirement. So logics can be developed mainly through if-else blocks, switch cases, for loops. Every graduate knowing why do we require if block, why do we require else block, for loop, switch cases. Every graduate, even BSc person also knows about that. If block, else block, switch cases, for loops, while loop to while loop. But while coming to the customer requirement, applying if-else blocks, applying loops, most of the 90% of people not getting a idea on how to use if-else blocks, for loops, switch cases. That is mainly through practice you will be getting. I will be showing lot of examples in this 2 months itself. Every day, we will be focusing on logical coding development. Logical coding development. Definitely, you will become an expert on logical related programs, whichever expecting interviewer from you. For the fresher interviews, whatever logical related. So, let us consider a simple example like, I am giving one number. Your program has to check whether that number is a prime number or not. Very simple logic. How to apply that one? What kind of loops required? What kind of logic? What kind of conditional statements required? Just to keep thinking again and again, 200% you will be getting an idea. So we are doing almost close to 400 or 500 examples on logic. No one can feel like I am poor in the programming after my 2 months sessions. Everybody will think like programming is not difficult. Only the thing is we have to put more effort. I cannot say like this is very sufficient to develop any kind of bigger projects. Definitely, this will be sufficient to start developing. While developing, you will be coming across much more complex logics. 200% you can able to achieve, you can able to evolve through the basic information whatever I am providing. In addition to logical coding, definitely data structures. Almost all, even computer science students also feeling difficulty on the data structures. It's not a difficult, very easy. I will be going through almost like a 30-40 data structures programs. You will become an expert in the same. Everybody will feel like data structures and even algorithms are very simple. Got it? So no need of bothering about programming incapabilities. Something like I'm poor in the programming, I'm not capable in the programming. No need of worrying. So, programming is nothing but if-else blocks, switch cases, for loops. Please observe. You can talk to your senior. In a day, how many times he is using variable, if-block, for loops, switch cases? 90% of development is only variable management, if-blocks, else-blocks, switch cases, for loop, while loop methods. Not like something like a very, very advanced things. Programming is nothing but very basic variable managing, if block, else block, switch cases, loops. If you know this one, then you can become an expert in the programming. I'll make you an expert in the programming. Just you should follow me and you have to practice minimum 3-4 hours. I will be releasing some even video classes also because of the time constraint. Within 2 months, lot of things we have to cover may not be possible in our regular 3 hours classes. Some of the logical coding, I will be releasing some of the video files. You have to go through that also. logical coding, lot of programs are there, lot of time is required. Within 2 months, we can finish off all the things. So daily try to spend 3 to 4 hours additionally, that is sufficient. Don't bother about whether you are a CSE student or civil engineer. Please observe. Don't bother whether you have a 50% or 90% in your graduation or post-graduation or 10th standard or plus 2. Don't bother about whether you are very comfortable in the communication or you are able to manage only technical things. So don't bother about whether you are strong in the programming or not. I will make you very strong in the programming. I can give a guarantee, like you will be getting placed within 2 months span if you are showing 70% progress in my classes. Once in a week there will be some exams which will be explaining about where you are. After finishing 2 months, there will be one cumulative test. In that cumulative test, just to score 70%. In the cumulative test, just to score 70%, that is sufficient for me to place you in the industry with a minimum 2 lakhs package within 10 days. I don't require more than 10 days. Before starting your final SEM exams, you will be having an offer letter, no matter of percentages, branches, no matter of how you are in the past, whether you are very sincere or not. Just to take 2 months serious, that is sufficient. Before starting your final SEM exams, I am here to place you. But you should show minimum 70% in my content, whatever content I am driving. Every week there will be some tests in the online itself. You can just practice and you can check it out where you are. After 2 months, in all covered concepts, there will be one cumulative test. Score 70% in that test. I don't require to know what is your branch, what is your previous percentages. I will be placing you with a minimum 2 lakhs package. But average, there will be 3.5 as well. There are companies which are giving 5 lakhs, 6 lakhs. I am just telling like a minimum package. It will be pure development. Don't bother about call center, don't bother about BPO or anything, not tech, something like a tech support or any kind of maintenance. It's a pure development, completely development related. With a minimum, I am saying like a minimum 2 lakhs package. There might be 3 and 4 lakhs also. It's purely based on which company you are choosing. Even like after getting an offer, within 1 day, you can accept or reject. If you are rejecting, you will be allowed for other companies. Minimum 10 companies I'll show you. I will be sending 10 companies to your college itself. Lot of companies are there in Bangalore. Unfortunately, no company able to find suitable students. Maybe you can observe your seniors, how sincere they were in their final year and even after finishing the final year. If you are comparing them, you can come to know. No one is serious nowadays. If you are serious, 200%, the companies will run behind you. Just to put 2 months serious, that is very sufficient for me to please you. This is the time to put more seriousness. So we don't require a vast study. We require a very smart study which will be helping you to get a breakthrough. Not only getting a breakthrough. After getting a breakthrough, assume you got 2 lakhs package in the beginning. Within 2 years, your salary may go to 8 to 10 lakhs. Definitely. Most of the people are looking for something like a Facebook or Google and all. Yes, you can also enter into Facebook or Google. It's not a difficult. Only the thing is programming capabilities. Initially, they might be having a 10 or 15 rounds leave it. Enter into small company. with a 2 lakhs or 3 lakhs package. Work there for 2 years or 3 years. Become an expert in the specified area. Then you can enter into Facebook or Google or Amazon, whatever is required. Whatever content I'm going through in the programming, like a logical coding and data structures, those are very much required for any company. So my sincere advice, just to go to our website, you will be finding the course content. In that course content, you will be finding logical coding. Even CSC people also may not be developed. Those many examples in their lab or in their any kind of subjects. Lot of things I have designed, lot more I incorporated under logical coding. All these programs we will be covering. Similar kind of programs I will be giving a homework. Same programs I will be recording and I will be sending to you in form of a video. But my effort is within 2 months, specified content should get over. Within 2 months, we should have a final cumulative test. After 2 months, within 10 days, we had to conduct a drives with a minimum 10 companies, with all the people whoever scored minimum 70%. So if any person scored 70% after 2 months, come on, after 2 months, one person scored 70%, unable to place in the initial 10 companies. Afterwards, what is his like? What we will be doing? So let him to finish off his graduation, like a final semester, all the exams and all. Definitely, we will be keep forwarding the requirements, or like a day-to-day requirements. He can keep attending all the requirements. Till he get placed, he will be with Lara only. If at all he is coming to Bangalore, then he can keep attending the classes in the Lara premises also. There will be a separate admission, but definitely it's a very reduced price. Even though he is not attending the classes, he can attend all the drives. Please observe, after 2 months, whoever scoring more than 70%, for those people, minimum 10 drives before starting their final semester exams. Assuming that 10 drives, a particular person unable to place, then let him to undergo all the final sem exams, let him to finish off his graduation. Then, if he is coming to Bangalore, he can attend the drives in the Bangalore. If he is going to Chennai or Hyderabad or Noida or anywhere, he can able to attend there itself. We will be keep forwarding all the requirements. I can say like a minimum one every day, just because of those many requirements are there in many companies, more companies. Every day, minimum one requirement you will be getting. 200% you will be getting placed. If you are very smart in the preparation, if you are scoring more than 70%, initial 10 companies are highly sufficient to get placed. Unfortunately, if you are unable to place in the initial 10 companies, don't worry. We will be with you till you get placed. After finishing graduation, you will be keep attending interviews wherever you are, either in the Bangalore city or somewhere else. So Lara Technologies, almost like 13 years back we have started. In 2005 we started. 13 years are there in the industry, only for the trying. Every company knows about Lara Technologies, not only in Bangalore, but across India. Every company, all my students are in different companies. So don't worry about the placement. Most of the people worrying about the placement. Only cowards has to worry on placements. You're not a coward. Just to show sincerity for 2 months. No matter the branch, no matter the year of pass or branches, any negative, leave it. I'm here to place you. Only the thing is, you should follow. I found out the best information, whatever is required to place a fresher. Based on my experience, I identified an essential information, whatever is required to place a fresher. With that essential information, I'm coming in front of you for 2 months just to follow me. 200% I can get it. even you are unable to place before your final semester exams, afterwards also maximum 1 month after finishing your final sem exams, if at all you are unable to place in the first initial 10 companies, I'm guaranteeing for all the students, if you show more than 70% progress in my classes before starting your final sem exams, minimum 10 drives I will be arranging for you. In the 10 drives, try to get place. Most of the people definitely will get place. If at all, if it is not proper, unable to place, don't worry. Finish off your certificate, finish off your exams, then come to any city. Wherever you are, we will be placing you. Assume you move to Hyderabad or you move to Mumbai, we are ready to place you. It's not that difficult. I found everything what is required to the companies. I found everything which is not available from the students. I'm here to make a bridge between students and the companies. No matter whether you are in Noida or you are in Calcutta, I can place you. Only the thing is, you should follow me. If you are not following me, 200% I cannot place. It's not like a backdoor entry. It's not like aptitude, reasoning or communication. If any person placing through aptitude, reasoning and communication, then it is not a great effort of institute. Please observe. If a person having a more than 70% in the graduation and he's very strong in aptitude, reasoning and communication, then definitely he can get placed anywhere. If any institute is placing that type of person, then it's not a credit of institute, it's a credit of his own student credit too. According to me, I'm least bothering about the top person. I'm least bothering about the people who are having a good communication, good aptitude, good reasoning. I'm bothering about average student. Let everybody getting placed. Let everybody. In the initial example, in the first example I told, civil engineer, after 5 years, everybody entering into the software. Let everybody entering into the software now itself, rather than wasting 5 years. Most of the average students are thinking like, I may not be suitable for the software. I may not be like getting a job. Yes, you may not be getting a job immediately. You will be getting a job. Lot of rooms are there in the software. Show more progress, show more seriousness, 200% you will be getting placed. I'm here. Please observe. Just to follow me blindly. At the same time, don't neglect your graduation. Whatever subjects you have to write, so whatever preparation, keep going through that. But I understood, like, almost in the graduation, final year students wasting their time with functions, with all friends and all. Definitely we should require friends, we should require functions. But at the same time, we should not lose our career. So our parents and well-wishers are keep on dreaming about our career. So definitely we have to spend minimum effort for our career. That minimum effort is sufficient for me. Attend 3 hours of classes every day and 3 hours of practice. Just 6 hours for me for 2 months. Saturday, Sunday, absolutely I'm leaving you. I'm not taking any classes on Saturday, Sundays. Very effectively, in the smart way, with very good plans, utilize your time for graduation study, graduation subjects study, any labs study, and arrears, any backlogs study, and also continuing this one. 200% you will be getting placed. Let me go through any of the chat messages. So if you have any messages, if you have any doubts or anything, maybe even college, either like a HOD or TPO or any the concerned person, please mention your any kind of doubt. I'm not finding any doubts in the chat window. Please, if you have any kind of doubts, you can. So let us see whether I covered all the points in the agenda or not. Today's our agenda. So maybe sir, left side you can see counseling session, almost you might have understood everything. Which technologies are highly used in the industry? Are you worrying about less percentages in the education? Are you worrying about your non-IT branches? Are you worrying about difficulty in the aptitude, difficulty in the reasoning, difficulty in the GD? Are you thinking about you are a just average student, how to enter into the dynamic software field? Are you worrying about expenditure to learn the IT skills in the cities? Please observe, after finishing your graduation, coming to Bangalore, spending almost 3-4 months to learn these skills, instead of wasting 3-4 months expenditure, why can't you utilize your final semester time very effectively? Try to utilize your final semester time very effectively. Are you worrying about programming is very difficult? Are you worrying about logics and data structures? All these 11 points I have covered. Please observe, not at all. So we didn't miss anything, everything you understood. Then come to the right side, road plan of 100% placement program. To whom this project is designed? I already told it's designed for average graduate. Don't worry about toppers. Average graduate, definitely with a 200% he can able to place with a minimum salary of 2 lakhs. Development side, not in any other side. So what are the prerequisites? I already told, no prerequisites. You should require a graduate brain. You don't require any previous knowledge in the system. Even mechanical, civil engineer, you don't require any kind of prerequisites. Which are the skills covering? So mainly 3 diverse streams we are covering. Salesforce, Angular specific, the third one. Logical coding, data structures and algorithms. The detailed course content you can find in the website. Even we are sharing to all TPOSRs and HODSRs. You can ask from them also. How much commitment? I already told you. In addition to 3 hours classes, every day, just 3 more hours commitment with a very seriousness. Serious 3 hours commitment, 200% sufficient. How much duration? Just 2 months. Which are the projects developing? One main project in the Salesforce. In the Salesforce, I will be developing a project called Campus Tracker. I will be giving the detailed picture about the Campus Tracker. I'll give some kind of information in the beginning itself. Same, we will be developing by using Salesforce technology. Then the second one, a simple prototype development in the Angular. I can say like a crude development. It's not like a major development. It's only a simple crude development by using Angular. Then when Tribes will start, as soon as content is getting over, within 2 months. By April middle, Tribes will be started. What kind of companies? Every company is a very stable company, not like a startup company 6 months back, 1 year back or 2 years back started companies. All stable companies with a minimum 8 to 10 years back started, mid-range companies, and also MNC companies, not like a call center related, not like a tech support, not like a BPO, a pure technical development, not the very, very startup companies. It should be like a very stable. The companies should give minimum 2 lakhs package, but there are companies which are giving 3.5 to 4 lakhs. So what is the salary package? I already told minimum 2 lakhs, but on average, there will be 3.5 to 4 lakhs also. Don't worry about the salary package. Lot of companies are there. If you are not happy with any salary package of any company, you don't require to join in that. I am providing 10 companies. In that 10 companies, I can say like a more than 6-7 companies will be more than 3.5 lakhs. Only 2-3 companies might be 2 lakhs salary. You don't require to join in that companies. After selecting, take 1 day time to confirm whether you want to join or not. You can find out through your well-wishers through internet whether the company giving a good career to you or not. If you find like that company may not be good, then you can reject that, keep attending another drives. It is not difficult. How long our support will be? Till you get placed. Till you get placed, but you should show minimum 70% progress in our exams. If you are not scoring minimum 70% in our exam, then 200% we won't do anything for you. Please observe. It's purely quality based drive. It is not like a recommendation drive or maybe a references drive. It's only quality based. You should score minimum 70%. That is sufficient for me to place you in multiple companies. Till you get placed, we provide a support. How long will be taking to get placed? I told like initial 10 companies will be sufficient. If at all, unfortunately, you are unable to get placed, after finishing your graduation, maximum 1 month time. I already told minimum 1 drive I will be sharing to you, which will be nearer to your city, not only in Bangalore. You don't require to come to Bangalore to attend the drives. Whichever city is nearer, that will be sufficient. So you can keep attending there. Got it. Some people are asking, is it possible to access the same classes in other timings? As of now, I clearly decided like a 2 to 5. If you have any concerns on accessing these classes in other than 2 to 5 time, you can talk to Surendra. So let us think it out. But every day classes are recording. Every day classes will be recording. These classes will be uploading into YouTube and giving access to one email ID for one college. Please observe. We are uploading to YouTube and giving access only to one email ID to one college. Through that email ID, you can able to access in throughout the day whenever you want it. You can access multiple times also. But like all people accessing from the either lab or from the seminar hall, in whichever way you are attending the class today, in the same way. So there is a possibility of accessing other timing also, but don't look for everyday recorded classes. It's always advisable to go for the live. Go for the live. We will be creating one Facebook group. Whatever doubts you have, you can enter into the Facebook. Instantly, I will be explaining. Please observe. You don't require to come to the projector to type your doubts. We will have one common Facebook group. So definitely everybody having a smartphones nowadays. Through your smartphone, you can access the Facebook group and you can enter your doubt instantly in the class itself. I will be explaining the same doubt in my delivery. So then, some people are asking about like a money and all. So this money, already Surendra might have explained, Surendra's team might have explained. If you find difficulty on any kind of any packages, you can keep talking to Surendra. Surendra will be helping you on any kind of something like a either increasing or decreasing, whatever customization required, he will take care of that one.
Hello everyone.
So any other doubts, anybody? How to join and the fee structure, please observe. The classes will not be individual student. Classes will be college wise. All the students from one college can attend through one connection. We will be giving one connection to one college. College management. Please try to allocate one coordinator for our classes. Coordinator will take care of connecting to our classes and maintaining progress of our college, our classes. Students, if any like a disturbances or any kind of difficulties, you can get in touch with Mr. Surendra. Surendra will take care of managing all these things. One connection for one college. No individual connection to the students. Then the fee structure, there are three different packages. You can ask to your either a business executive or a Surendra. Can we access class at our available time? Yes, I have already answered the same. Can you explain how to join in the classes and fee details? Please, fee details purpose, get in touch with your business developer or business development team or Surendra. Good information. Okay. To understand IT industry, good, even first sim. Yes, 10th class students also can understand my delivery. First year, second year, third year, any student can attend. While coming to the placements, we'll consider only for the final year students. Pre-final year students or maybe second year students, we won't consider. Please observe, anybody can able to attend, understand, can gain. Coming to the placements, only for final year students. Yes. So I'm just walking through all the messages. So almost everybody mentioned like, no doubts. So lot of people mentioned their college name. So hi to everybody. Thank you for attending this session. So some people found like a volume is little not proper. So volume related things, it's only because of net speed. If good net speed is there, you will not be finding any kind of volume issues. So today I supposed to cover some more things also, mainly setup things. But some college people already made a request like they have a college winding at 4 o'clock. So better to wind up now. I'll continue all setups tomorrow. Tomorrow our classes will be between 1 to 4. Please observe. Just because of some of the colleges winding by 4 o'clock. So our classes will be between 1 to 4. Tomorrow 1 to 4, tomorrow I'll show you each and every information about what kind of software is required, what is the clear setup, setting up your systems with the required software. Afterwards, we'll start the detailed information about all these three things. My sincere advice, every student, please try to download. Try to download our course content. It will be available. It is available in our website. Vinod has been. So Vinod already kept course content, detailed course content in the website itself. Let me show the same. Yeah. detailed course content, please try to download. Please try to download. This is the detailed course content. Everybody, please observe. Go to laratechnology.com. Everybody, go to laratechnology.com. Course content. Under course content, the last one. Campus to corporate. Please observe. This is the course content you have to. Course content. You can download this same file. You can share to your seniors. You can supply, you can send it to your well-wishers, whoever working in the industry for the past 10 years. Then you can come to know importance, strength of this course content. Please try to download this one, everybody. Campus to Corporate. Under laratechnology.com, course content, Campus to Corporate. Then, all the colleges, whichever showing the interest to involve in this program, every college, whoever required to show, required to attend this program, please try to fill up this simple form. Surendra provided a simple form. Interested colleges, please try to fill this form. Surendra will be getting in touch with you to explain whatever queries you have, whatever like a even fee structure, everything he will be getting in touch with you. So this is all about first day content for training and 100% placement. Please remember, it's a 100% placement. Got it? So tomorrow we'll assemble sharply by 1 o'clock. Before 1 o'clock, finish off your lunch and assemble to the corresponding places like a lab or semester. Switch off the mobiles. Tomorrow we will show you Facebook group. You can join everybody. Whenever you have a doubt, you can log in. And my sincere advice to you, nobody will get a doubt. Even 10th standard student also will not be getting a doubt. My delivery is for every average, below average student. Everybody can able to understand. Still, if you are getting any doubt, you can. You can mention the same doubt in the Facebook group. So myself or my team immediately will be responding to you. So thank you. Thanks a lot. This is what my simple counseling session for 2009 young graduates. So we will see tomorrow more about our program. Enjoy karo. All the very best. Thank you. Thanks to all HODs, placement cell officers and principals for giving this opportunity to your young kids. So thank you all this 2009. Pass out young kids. Thanks a lot. We'll see you tomorrow. And thanks to my business managers who are bringing these many colleges. Thanks to Surendra, coordinate all these people. Finally, thanks to Vinod for completely our smooth session. Thanks a lot. Thanks to classroom people also. Enjoy karo. All the best. We'll see you tomorrow.